Hi, let's talk about the laryngeal cavity. So the story of the laryngeal cavity really begins at the laryngeal inlet, and that is the space through which air may move between the laryngopharynx to the outside and the laryngeal vestibule, which is within the larynx. So we can see kind of mounds of mucosa here. That mucosa will be invested by muscle. There's going to be arytenoid cartilages there. So this is the interarytenoid notch. And then extending from the arytenoids up to the epiglottis, and I'll erase this, so that we can flank it there, are the airy epiglottic folds. Those airy epiglottic folds are the folds in which the cuneiform cartilages may be found. They also help to decide the shape and the patency of the laryngeal inlet. Within, there are airy epiglottic ligaments that are part of the quadrangular membranes. Also, we can see with the wall of the pharynx incised and reflected away, there's space between the larynx, let me erase this, and the wall of the pharynx. These are known as the piriform recesses or piriform fossae. And sometimes materials that are consumed may get stuck here, and a person might feel as though there's a bit of a lump in their throat. The laryngeal cavity is the space bounded by the larynx. And here we can see the posterior aspect of the larynx has been cut and reflected away. We can see the cricoid cartilage within here. So here are the arytenoid cartilages. There is the epiglottis there. And so the space between the arytenoid cartilages and the epiglottis there is known as the laryngeal vestibule. Makes sense, because whenever you walk into a building, sometimes you walk into a vestibule. Just below that space, there are folds, and these folds are actually covering over ligaments that run between the arytenoid cartilages and the thyroid cartilage anteriorly. And these are called the vestibular folds, sometimes called the false vocal folds. These have a protective function for the vocal folds. Now the space between them is known as the rima vestibuli. Below these folds is the laryngeal ventricle. And then distal to the laryngeal ventricle are another set of folds. These folds are formed by ligaments going from the vocal processes of the arytenoid cartilages out to the thyroid cartilage, and there's some muscle in there as well, thyroarytenoid vocalis muscle. Those are the vocal folds, oftentimes referred to as the vocal cords. These are the structures which vibrate during phonation. And the space between them is known as the rima glottidis. Now below the vocal folds is the infra glottic cavity. And then below the margin of the cricoid cartilage, that infraglottic cavity transitions into the trachea, which is the passageway that's going to conduct air between the larynx and the primary bronchi. It's quite a long section of conductive pathway for the respiratory system. Thank you very much for your time.